74 is when we downsized engines. You know, first they had a 366, 364 engine, and then they changed it to 358. And I remember in 75, we was at Riverside, and Benny came to me with a set of pistons and said, "Man, I just got a set of pistons for Daytona engine." So I looked at him, I said, "Those are drag race pistons. You can't run them in an old track car." "Oh, yeah, the guy says you can." Okay, so we come back to the shop. Benny and LG went to Bill Francina to borrow money advanced, you know, for the season to race on. So wow. I build that one engine, and then I go through, I ask, "Well, we're going to build another new engine for Daytona?" "No, can't afford it." I said, "Well," I went through all that stuff that we'd blowed up in 74 and put an engine together. So we show up at Daytona.
I know where this is leading.
I believe I do, too.
Anyway, Benny said, "Let's put the new engine in, and we'll run it a couple laps, then we'll take it out and put that old engine in, and then we'll save the new engine for the race." "All right." Two laps, it blowed up. I said, "Well, now we got this engine. I wouldn't give you $200 for it. We're going to run and fight this whole time. You know, we have to practice. We have to qualify. We have to run the 125, 150, whichever. And then 500. Well, anyway, end up started 32nd. I wouldn't unload the pit equipment. So come down next to the end, that thing's still running, and he's running second place. David Pearson leading the race. He ends up spinning out, and then we end up in the lead. We win the race.
With an engine, you wouldn't give $200.
No, I wouldn't have, because it was out of scrap parts. So anyway, come in Victor Lane, and I and LG DeWitt was and Benny both. I've never seen two people. Well, it was just way beyond their wildest imagination, especially LG DeWitt.
Yeah.
But it couldn't have happened to two better people than them. Anyway, I get to thinking, what size is that engine? Because we got to take it apart. Now, which crank did I put in? Because that was the difference in the crankshaft, the stroke. First, I don't even want to go check it. They paged me. So
were you sweating it?
Oh, yeah. Who would have thought we was going to win the Daytona 500 with that engine? So anyway, I go in there and take it apart, and it was okay. But thank the Lord for that.
I did not know all of
that. Wow. That's why we do this podcast. You bring up the 75 Daytona 500, but another event in Benny's career that really kind of lives on in history is the Rockingham race in 1973 when he wrecks and everybody piles in and starts to help put that car back together. Put that into perspective. Just how badly was that car torn up?
Well, you know, you'd end up wrecking it, and it got the door bars. So NASCAR said, you know, we can't let you on a racetrack like that. Well, we don't have no spare bars no place. And there was one guy, and I can't recall his name. We built his engine for him, and his car was down at the other end of the garage. Went down and got that race car, and he wasn't around. So we bring it up there, and we cut the door bars out of it. Well, we get it going back on the racetrack, and the bottom line is, you know, Benny ended up winning the championship by us being able to do that. But when we run into that poor fella that we'd cut the door bars out of, he was very irate. He was ready to kill somebody. So we finally told him, "We will put your race car back together as good as new." So he was okay once he seen, you know, what the end result was and the reason we done it.
So you basically swiped the roll bars?
We didn't ask permission at all. We just cut his race car up. He'd have seen us cutting it up, he would have took a fit.
Incredible.
But there were several people that jumped in to help make that happen. That was a big day.
Yeah.
Benny winning the championship.